Madison Square Garden, we're number one and number three. Here, we're number one and number two. So we broke our own record tonight. Ridiculous, considering the week we had. But amazing. Very happy. Let's see. Fight of the night. I don't think there's any. Khabib, that fight is the fight of the night. Mercier gets a bonus. And Chris for the stoppage of Joe Luzon. They all won $50,000. Congratulations to them. Anybody have any questions? Go ahead.
Yeah, Dana, I just want to get your thoughts on Khabib before we sign. Obviously, Al was gutsy as well, but I want to hear what you thought about Khabib and just the whole week. I mean, everything that he went through to be able to take, you know, three different opponents in a week and all the melee and all that stuff and still turn into a performance like that.
I think Khabib's performance was amazing. I honestly believe there's three guys in this company or in fighting that would have stayed and done and stayed the fight. No doubt Conor McGregor, okay, Cowboy Cerrone, and Khabib. I mean, the stuff that this guy went through, you know, physically, emotionally, mentally, this week, many people. I've been on the side where the guy who is the champ and is had a full camp won't take a guy who was coming off a short note. I mean, it just doesn't happen. And what that guy's been through, and he came in and he fought. And much respect to Al, too. You know, he didn't show up for a paycheck. He came to win. He's a tough guy.
Just to be clear for the record, the belt that Khabib has is the only belt, right? No Tony Ferguson, no Conor McGregor, no belts.
Say that again?
The belt that Khabib has is now the only belt.
That's it. That's the only belt.
Okay. Yep. So with that in mind, I'm curious. I mean, after the fight, he calls out George St. Pierre and says that's the fight he wants. You know, not Conor McGregor, not Tony Ferguson. What were your thoughts on that? Is that a fight or shoot? Yeah, I mean, do you like the idea of him fighting George St. Pierre? Do you like the idea of, I mean, I know you said you
I don't have any ideas after this week, man. My brain is scrambled and I am a physical mess. I'm praying for Sunday. I'm so glad that this is over and it was just such a positive outcome for the company. And again, I have to thank the fans too, you know. There were no returns. Actually, tickets picked up and sold, and it's incredible. So, thank you to the fans. Like some of the people when I was walking in, some of the fans were saying, "Thank God you didn't cancel this. I flew in from London. It cost me $10,000 this weekend," and things like that. So, shit show turned into something pretty good.
I did want to ask you real quickly. I saw you talking with the commission page side tonight. You know, she had done an interview and said that Paul Felder was never even presented as an option to the commission. Can you comment on it and clarify what happened?
Yeah, let me tell you this. The commission was awesome. The commission was outstanding, and I want to thank them for hanging in there with us this week too. I mean, listen, they have their rules and regs here, and it is what it is, you know.
Okay. Seems like some confusion, but. Seemed like some confusion that you would hope to get all in there, but they said that the neighboring was considered.
Yeah, and just to clear some up too, I don't want to give this guy any publicity because he loves it, but that greasy, slimy rat, Espinoza, talking about how, oh, we break the rules and all this other shit. What is that? What's that guy? Oh my God. Just keep trying to be HBO and don't worry about what the fuck we're doing, you slimy little rat.
Oh, he's Showtime, actually.
Just last thing for me, Dana. Real quick, I know it's only been 24 hours since we last talked to you, but any updates at all on the Conor McGregor situation from him? Any change at all in that situation?
Is what?
Just the situation in general, your relationship, his legal situation.
We talked.
Any updates?
We talked yesterday.
How did it go?
Yeah, it's good. I mean, I think that there's a mutual respect between us, and, you know, obviously this week, I had so many things thrown at me this week. To focus on the show was insane. We'll get back and we'll focus on Conor McGregor.
Right now, Dana, you don't have any firm, you know, plan of attack or of what you're going to do action-wise with Conor?
No. No, I'm no.
You, you obviously had something in mind before he gets to New York. Were you looking at
he didn't come to New York to do anything with me. He jumped on a plane with all those guys to come. not true. You came to New York for Khabib.
What were you thinking?
You didn't come here to meet me.
What were you thinking, though, that date-wise, as to when he was fighting?
I didn't even know Conor was here. It was like this thing at the press conference where a couple of guys at the press were like, they acted like they knew something, like he was coming here to meet, or he was coming here, you know? So, no, I didn't know anything about him coming here.
But did you have a date in mind for him? Like, you wanted him to fight when? Even before all this happened?
September. We had talked about him fighting in September.
Do you think that's still possible at all?
I don't know. You can't ask me anything about Conor. I don't know anything about Conor. I haven't thought about it. There's nothing to think about this week except for this event.
I think in every weight class, you want the guy who's the champion to be considered, to feel like he is the best fighter in the division. Did you feel that way at the end of the fight with Khabib tonight?
Did I feel like he? Yeah. I mean, he was unbelievable. The fact that Khabib got through this week, stayed in the fight, went out and fought tonight. It's just that guy. You know, he was just telling me, I haven't been home to see my kids since September. You know, he's telling me everything that he's been through to get to tonight, and then to get here this week. It's draining, man. I'm drained, and I didn't do shit. I'm drained. You know, I couldn't imagine going through the week that I went through and then having to go fight. That's just, I can't imagine.
Hi Dana, Igor Lazar from Los Angeles, Russia. Do you have any agreements about UFC tournament in Russia? And if I understand right, Khabib will not participate in this event.
About us coming to Russia?
Yeah.
I've been saying it for a long time, we're definitely coming to Russia. But that's all the information I have about that. And that's all I got.
And how about Khabib?
Khabib fighting in Russia? Is that what you're asking me?
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, that would make a lot of sense. I think if we go to Russia, we'll probably have a fight first without him, and then it would be awesome to have a huge fight with him.
Kevin? David, could you possibly do Khabib and Conor in Russia with security situation?
Could I
do that?
Could I what?
Could you do Khabib versus Conor in Russia?
Oh my God.
With security?
I don't know. Seriously, I really can't answer any Conor questions till I, you know.
This question.
He's got to go to court in June.
This question, you know, indirectly about Conor. Is the company in better or worse shape today after the events of this week? You know, because there's positives and negatives. The positive, obviously, you kept the show together and had a great night. You know, the negative, of course, your biggest star is, you know, arrested and looked like a fool. I mean, so is the company in better or worse shape than it was coming into the week?
We're in way better shape. Way better shape. In a perfect world, it'd be great if Conor didn't show up and do that. And obviously, I didn't see that coming, or I would have tried very hard to prevent that. We broke a record tonight. We broke the arena record for the highest gross. We broke our own record, and we didn't just break it. We blew it out of the water. We beat it by almost $1 million. So the pay-per-views were great too. So yeah, it was awesome.
I mean, is there any tangential damage that comes with, you know, the impressions that were created by what happened the other day? Because I know how hard you guys have worked to create a different image.
Right. But what happened. We can't change that, you know, unfortunately. But, yeah, we just have to listen. People say to me, you know, oh, this looks so bad for the sport and everything else. I agree. It doesn't look good. But at the end of the day, there's a lot worse that goes on than all the other sports. So. Take a dolly through a window any day.
Yeah. And then from, you know, just to talk about Khabib, when you look at the level of grappling he has, you know, everybody knows what that is, but he went in there against Al, and he stood and struck with him for two or three rounds, right? And I mean, you know, Al didn't train for a five-round fight, I get that, but I mean, he looked pretty good striking too. I mean, he's developing into an all-around fighter, not just a one-dimensional guy, would you not agree?
Yeah, I mean, it's obviously his move, putting you down on the ground when he pins and traps that arm, and then just start smashing it. It's a lot tougher to do with a guy who's a wrestler like Al. Al's got good ground game, strong kid too, and has knockout power. You know, Al said it at the press conference, I have everything to gain and nothing to lose, whereas Khabib has everything to lose. I think that's the type of fought that Khabib fought tonight, and on top of all the stuff that's happened to him too.
David, just any thoughts on Rose Namajunas' title defense tonight? How did you just think she looked, and what do you feel about Joanna Jedrzejczyk now that she's in that kind of weird 0-2 contender spot that we've seen some fighters in the past?
Who, Rose?
Yeah, Rose is in position now.
No, Rose looked incredible. I mean, if you look at how much she's grown since the Ultimate Fighter, she looked amazing tonight, and Joanna did too. It was a great fight. I had a 2-2 going into the last round, and it was awesome. I was literally just in the back doing an interview, and I'm sitting there talking, and Rose is standing right in front of me doing an interview, and she's back there walking around and doing her thing. How many fights have we seen with those type of leg kicks where as soon as the fight is over, they walk around a little bit, and then the announcement, they can't even walk, they have to be carried out of the octagon, and then I'll go in the back and you'll see people on wheelchairs or they get transported. That little girl is walking around back there on both legs. It's pretty impressive.
And I only ask this because you didn't mention Stephen Espinosa on your own, but Floyd Mayweather did an interview tonight on the Lara broadcast, and he said if he were to fight in the UFC, he would want Showtime and CBS to be involved. So with that said, and your thoughts on Espinosa?
That ain't happening.
So that could be a roadblock to Floyd actually fighting in the UFC if that's...
Yeah, we'll do it on HBO.
Dana, you've had a bit of a rocky relationship with Iaquinta over the years, or the last year or so. What do you make of him now?
You know, I've had rocky relationships with just, you should know that, Aaron, with just about, everybody at one point in time. But, I've never not respected Al Iaquinta. I think Al was more upset with us than we were with Al. I don't know what his, what he was upset about, but we weren't upset with him. It happens. Listen, we're all in business together and these things happen. But I have a lot of respect for him for stepping up. And taking this fight.
And have you talked to GSP recently?
Who, GSP?
Yeah.
No, we haven't talked recently.
Okay. So you don't know if he's at all interested in this
no.
challenge?
No, I haven't talked to GSP, and I definitely haven't talked to GSP about fighting.
Okay.
I think that I hit his agent month and a half ago about something, but I don't remember off the top of my head exactly what it was. It was about a fight, but I don't know. It might have been Woodley. I don't remember.
Is it possible to clarify what you said about Brock yesterday? Because you said he's still under contract. How is he under contract while still under contract with WWE?
Because he retired from UFC. He retired from MMA.
So when he came at UFC 200, he signed a multi-fight deal?
I think so. I don't remember exactly. But yeah, Brock still has a contract with us.
Okay, and has he told you that his intention is to return?
Has he told me what?
That his intention is to return to UFC?
He wants to come back.
Yeah, so that picture you took, was that sort of when he told you that?
Yeah.
Okay. Are you going to WrestleMania tomorrow?
Did what?
Are you going to WrestleMania tomorrow?
Yeah.
Okay. For Brock or for Ronda?
For Ronda.
Okay.
Yeah.
And the last one...
I didn't even know Brock was in it until you just said that.
Come on.
I swear to God, I didn't know that.
I think it's the main event.
I've been a little busy.
Sure. when do you expect to announce your TV plans for 2019 and beyond, the contract?
When do I...
Do you expect to announce your TV, the news of where you're going, like what's going on with the TV contract?
I guess when it's done.
Is it close?
I think so.
Can you tell us what to do?
No.
Any other questions?
Yeah, hi, Dan. You mentioned on Wednesday that this was a bit of an apology card because of the last one. I wouldn't say an apology card is needed because this was really good, but it was such a, as you said, shit show. What are we getting next time? Are we getting 5 title fights and Brock Fedor? What are we getting?
Hey, I'll tell you what, obviously we were bringing an incredible incredible card here with this trip. But this card was good tonight. It was very good. And obviously, I would have liked a different outcome on the main event for it to be Tony versus Khabib. But we pulled it off, man. It was good fights. It was entertaining. The crowd was into it. And every time we come to New York, we're trying to bring our A game. So.
What did you think of the crowd booing during some of the fights that maybe weren't deserved?
Yeah, it happens. We've been to places where that happens. Listen, the problem is when you just get done seeing this a beat fight, right? It's like every other fight. And now, no matter what happens, unless you just stand in front of each other and go toe to toe, it's just it's tough. It's tough to roll in after a fight like that. Go ahead, buddy.
Who will be next opponent for Rose Namajunas, or who is closer, Jessica Andrasch or maybe Karolina Kowalkiewicz after this fight against her?
Who do you want Rose to fight next?
I don't know. I'm not sure, but you know, she looks great. She looks amazing. I know Claudia has a fight coming up, and. Carolina looked good tonight. I don't know. We'll see. I usually don't talk about what's next the night of the fight.
But Carolina, what is your opinion about this fight, Carolina's fight?
What did you think of Carolina tonight?
Yeah, she looked great. She looked great. It was a great fight. And Felice looked good too. I mean, that was a tight fight, and both those guys are good. It was another good fight. Thank you guys. Appreciate it. Have a good night.